A requested topic from you all for us to talk about is SV40, or Simian Virus 40. This is part of the polyomavirus family and was originally identified in monkeys. It has a controversial history due to its contamination of polio vaccines in the 1950s. And that's because at the time, manufacturers were using monkey cells for viral replication to grow a lot of a weakened form of the polio virus to then use as a vaccine. However, some of those monkey cells were contaminated with SV40, leading that to be contaminated in the vaccines. But this led to better manufacturing processes and different tests in place to avoid this in the future. But fast forward a few decades, and now SV40 is being used in scientific and research fields, specifically for gene therapy. And that's because SV40 is able to infect a human cell. It's then proteins are dissociated and its DNA is encapsulated into an extra envelope. That extra envelope can cross our nucleus where our own DNA is housed, and then the SV40 DNA can be released. It's also in a circular form, which helps it integrate into our DNA, meaning that it can be copy-pasted in. So you can see that depicted here where our human DNA is in red, but the SV40 is in purple, which has been placed right inside, therefore allowing our own cells to start making proteins associated with SV40. But when it's used in the gene therapy space, this is using modified DNA. So there's a removal of the viral genome, so it's not going to have any of the SV40 proteins associated in that viral sequence. And we're going to place instead a gene of interest. And that would be, for example, of an individual who may be missing a particular gene, leading them to have a certain disease. But if we can try to give them that gene back, maybe we can alleviate some of their symptoms. So that gene of interest is inserted inside of the SV40 shell. It's then used to infect human cells and then insert that modified DNA into the human DNA. So you can almost think of the SV40 acting as a delivery mechanism. So make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin, and leave a comment below on the next topic you want to learn more about.